Welcome to our reading of The Watershed, Journey of a Raindrop. We'll follow our friend, Rio the Raindrop, through the Chesapeake Bay watershed. Our journey begins in the Appalachian Mountains. Our raindrop friend falls from a rain cloud and lands on the mountains. And how lucky Rio and these other drops are to fall in the Chesapeake Bay watershed. We have lots of adventures ahead of us on our journey downstream. All the raindrops must journey from our tall mountains downhill to the lowest point, the bay, following the rivers like a waterslide. Our journey, like a slide, might be fast, slow, steep, or flat, but it all leads downhill. Once we flow off the mountains into a river, our raindrop friend meets all the beautiful critters that enjoy these rivers too. Birds, deer, beavers, river otters, trout, and other species of fish, all the way to our insect friends, enjoy this river as much as Raindrop Rio does. Just downstream, what do we find but majestic cows cooling off in the river? Rio likes milk and ice cream as much as the next raindrop, but he does wish they didn't use the river as a bathroom. At least at this farm, there's nothing stopping their waste from entering this beautiful river and flowing downstream. But relief is around the corner, a shaded, shallow stream, a chance for Rio to slow down, cool down, and hang out with some cold water friends, like trout. Many thanks to the farmer that planted this riparian buffer zone to keep this part of the stream cool, clean, and healthy. But rest is short-lived for our raindrop pals. Our cool, calm stream has joined with others to form roiling, rocky, rough rapids. Our watershed slide is now at its steepest point, losing elevation and moving quickly downstream. As Rio rushes along, more friends join as rain falls over the city. Just like Rio picked up some pollution from cow fields, these raindrops pick up dirt, oil, and other harmful materials from the streets of a city. Yuck. But thankfully for Rio and friends, their next stop is in a wetland, where the water can slow down and filter through plants and soil. Like a car wash, the wetland leaves Rio and team at least a little cleaner. And what luck for the raindrops, Rio flows next into an oyster reef, another filter like our wetlands. Oysters hungrily filter water in search of algae snacks, filtering as much as 50 gallons of water a day. Rio's journey in our watershed ends in the bay, an estuary supporting an immense variety of plants and animals, including dolphins. We all contribute to the health of the watershed, and therefore to the health of the water downstream. What are some things that you can do to help protect the Chesapeake Bay and your local streams?